Hi there and welcome back to SolidWorks training. In this video I want to talk to you about sketch relations. Sketch relations are really important in defining sketches in SolidWorks. In our last video we talked about how you can build a sketch very easily and we started to talk about relations, but I want to go more in depth in this video. I'm going to go ahead and actually open a part that I've already created here. This is a spare tire carrier for a Jeep. You see these on modified off-road trucks. Here, I'll pull up a picture for you of what one looks like. Essentially, what this does is it allows you to take a big giant monster truck tire and mount it on the back of your truck rather than inside the truck where there's not as much room. Very handy. They're built out of tube steel. Pretty easy to build. And today, I want to show you we can model that pretty easily as I've done here. And in order to talk about sketch relations, I'm actually going to undo part of the model. And it's this part up here where you actually mount the tire. You can see there's a flat plate and that there's these bolts that the tire mounts on. And they all have to be located pretty precisely. So I'm going to go ahead and delete some of my work here. And we will go ahead and start again with building this part of the system. Alright, so again, if I want to open a sketch, I can just select the face that I want to open it on, and then I can get perpendicular to that face by coming up here to my views in the graphics area, and this shows you I have a front view, right view, left view, and it gives you a preview of what that would look like on each one. And I'm going to go ahead and just say make me normal to that. Okay, so it pulls it up so I'm looking straight on that face. And I know I want to draw that rectangular plate. If I come up to my sketch tools, you can see I have a bunch of different tools. One of them is a rectangle. If you click the down arrow, you can see there's different types of rectangles you can build. And I'm going to go ahead and choose my center rectangle. What the center rectangle tool does is you click in one spot and you drag it out and it creates for you this nice rectangle, okay, that's centered on where you clicked the first time. So I'm going to go ahead and click about right there. I think that's about the size I want, and I'll zoom in. And I'm going to dimension this guy, and I think I want it about 6.5 inches square. Alright, so I'll make it 6.5 inches by 6.5 inches. Okay, now the rectangle is fully defined for size, but it's not fully defined for location. You can notice if I grab one of the edges, I can move it around. Okay, but I need it to be centered here. I can grab the center point and move it around as well. Now you see these little green boxes? These are relationships or sketch relations. And if you mouse over them, you can see that it says coincident, point 1, line 5. Okay? And that's just a relationship between this line and this line, making the midpoints coincident. All right. So I want this to always be centered in this little area. And the best way to do that is to select a vertex. Okay, I want it to be horizontal to that. And then if I hold down Control, I can select the center point. Over in the Feature Manager on the left-hand panel, you can see I can add relations. I can make it horizontal, vertical, or coincident. In this case, horizontal makes it so that it always stays horizontal. It still can move around, I just can't move it up and down anymore. It's locked so that it's always horizontal with that point. Okay? If I undid that, and instead I said let's make it coincident, that fully defines the part, but it's no longer in the place I want it. Notice it's not centered. Coincident means that it's going to put the two points right on top of each other, glued, fixed forever. That's where they have to stay. I'm going to undo that. I don't want it coincident, and I'm going to stick with that horizontal relation. Okay? So it's stuck horizontal, and now I want it to be stuck in along that horizontal trajectory. I want it fixed so that the center point is right underneath the center point of the triangle. So again, I'll select the vertex, the two vertices that I want, and notice my context manager. It has those same relations for me. So rather than having to mouse all the way over to the left-hand panel, as soon as I get those two selected, my context toolbar shows me, hey, do you want to make that vertical? And I can say, yes, I do. Now it is fully defined, and I'm going to go ahead and extrude that. Again, I can either exit my sketch, or I can just go straight to the features in the command manager and click on Extrude Boss Base. I can roll around so I can get a better preview. In the feature manager, I want to set my depth. I'm going to use a quarter inch plate to make this. So I'll make it a quarter inch thick and hit check. Okay, so now I have my plate. Okay, looking good. If I zoom in, I'm going to want to draw on that surface. I could just go ahead and open a sketch, but I find it's always a good idea to first get looking directly at the sketch. So do use that normal to command. I'll show that to you again because it's really important. If you select a face, in your flyout menu here, you have normal to. If you click that, it makes it so that the drawing is completely perpendicular to that face. Okay? All right, so now I'm here, and now I can go ahead in my feature manager, or excuse me, my flyout tool, I can go ahead and click on new sketch. All right, so now I need to put the bolt pattern of my wheel that I want to mount on this right on this plate. How do we do that? Well, I think it's best to start by using a circle. All right, so we know the diameter of our bolt pattern. And I can go ahead and dimension my circle. This is a Jeep, and lots of Jeeps have a 5 on 5.5 bolt pattern, meaning 5 bolts on a 5.5 inch circle. So I want my circle to be 5.5 inches in diameter. All right, we've got that set, but again, the circle is not defined on where it should be. I'm going to go ahead now, and what I really want, I could dimension it. I could say, okay, well, the plate is 6.5 inches, so I know that I want this to be 3.25 inches up. But what happens if later I change the size of my plate? Maybe I make my plate 7 inches. This is no longer going to be in the middle. Okay? Well, actually, let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go ahead and say it's 3.5 inches from that edge, and I'll add another dimension here to say it's 3.25 inches, excuse me, from that edge. Now it's fully defined, everything looks good, and I'm just gonna, for demonstration purposes, extrude that out a quarter of an inch. All right, that looks fine. Now, check this out. If I select that base plate that we originally made, and I change its dimensions, let's make it 8 inches wide by 8 inches tall. Okay, and I did that just by selecting the plate and it pulled up those dimensions. And look at that, my circle is no longer centered in that plate. And that's not what I want. I want my circle to always be centered in the plate. This is why sketch relations are so important. Rather than using dimensions to center that circle, I should be using sketch relations that say put the center of the circle in the center of the square. All right, so I'm going to undo what I just did there and put my square back to the size I want. And let's go back in and edit this sketch. In fact, I'm just going to delete that extrusion because I don't actually want to extrude it. And notice I did that. Let me show you how I did that. I went over to the feature tree, I highlighted it, and then I hit delete. Okay. So now I just have my sketch, and I'm going to go back in and edit my sketch. How do I do that? Well, I can double click. That allows me to edit. Or I can come over here in the feature tree and click on the sketch, and then the flyout command manager shows me a little sketch symbol with a hand, and that means edit. Okay, so here I am. What I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and delete my 2 3.25 inch dimensions, and instead I'm going to mouse over this vertical line that's the edge of the plate, and I'm going to right click on it. When I right click, it opens up a bunch of different options. One of those is select midpoint. So if I select the midpoint of that line and then I hold down Control and I select the midpoint of the circle, notice that in my flyout menu I can now add a relation, or in my feature manager I can add the horizontal relation. Okay, so let's do that. We'll hit check to make it so. And let's do the same thing on the top line. All right, now I can select midpoint and select the center of the circle and say make it vertical. Now, my circle is fully defined with the diameter and the location of its center point using sketch relations. Let's go ahead and extrude this and let's do our test. If I extrude it a quarter inch, okay, and now I go back and I edit this plate and I change it to be 8 inches by 8 inches, watch what happens. The circle is still in the middle of the plate. This is really important. As you build more and more complex parts, you're going to want to be able to use these sketch relations to make sure that they stay in the with the design intent that you wanted. Meaning, was it most important that the circle be 3 1/4 inches off the edge, or was it more important that the circle be in the center of that square? And indeed, it was that it be in the center. Okay, again, we don't actually want to extrude that, so I'm going to delete the extrusion and I'm going to keep that circle though. All right, so let's go back and edit this sketch. Now, when I select the circle, remember over here in my feature manager, there's a bunch of different settings I can use. One of the options is for construction. I don't actually want to extrude a circle here. I just want to use that to set my bolt pattern up. So I'm going to click the For Construction box, and you notice that it changes the line type from being a solid line to being a long dash and a short dash. And that lets us know that it's for construction. All right, now I need to set some bolts on that bolt pattern. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add a circle right on this the larger bolt pattern circle. When I grab my circle tool, let me do that again up here, grab the circle tool. If I mouse around, I could just draw a circle anywhere, right? But I don't really want a circle right there. I want it to be right on the circle I've drawn here. So I can add my use sketch relations. If I grab the center point and I hold control and I grab the circle, you can see I have a couple different options. Make concentric. Let's see what that does. That puts this new circle I've drawn centered on the other circle. Very handy, but not what I want in this case. So let's undo that. I can make coincident. That is what I want. Okay, so now this circle, no matter what happens, is it lays on that larger bolt circle. That's the coincident relationship. You can make points coincident with other points or points coincident with lines. In this case, that's what I've done. I've made the point coincident with the bolt pattern circle. Now, where do I want to position this? Well, I'm going to go ahead and position it so that it is directly above the center. Okay, that worked pretty well, but it's still not fully defined. I need to give it a dimension. Let's say it's a half inch bolt. So we'll just make a half inch stud sticking out of there. Okay, that's great. I need a couple more bolt holes though. I want to show you a shortcut that I could have used the last time. When I got my circle tool, if I started my circle by highlighting the larger bolt circle, it automatically says, "Hey, I bet you want this circle to be coincident with the other one." So it adds an automatic relation. This is really handy and is going to be useful for us as we build more parts. Okay? So I'm going to go ahead and draw my other circles using that trick. Okay. So there's my five bolts, the five lugs on a wheel. Now all of these guys are different sizes, but I want them all to be half inch. I could go around and I could dimension each one of them individually. But then if I did that, what happens if I find out it's not a half inch lug, but it's 5/8? Then I would need to go around, double click on each dimension, and update it to be 5/8 of an inch instead. A better practice, if you have things that are going to be equal in size, is to make them equal. And you guessed it, there is a relationship to do that. If I hold control and select all of the circles, notice in my flyout manager, I can make them coradial, I can make them concentric, or I can make them equal. If I make them equal, they will now all be governed by this one half inch dimension. So if I change them all to be 3/4 of an inch, they all update their size to 3/4 of an inch. Another handy sketch relation, the equal. I'm going to put them back to half inch. Now, I need to locate these guys precisely as well. So I can drag them to about where I think they're going to be, right? Remember I said they're five, they're probably evenly spaced. But that doesn't actually give me the exact position. And so what I want to do is I want to use a center line. And I can grab the center line of my circle and come down to the origin and then come out to this guy. All right. And these center lines, notice I was being careful about where I picked. So I grabbed the center line of the circle and then the center of the larger bolt pattern and then the center line of this circle. Now I can add in the dimension, an angular dimension between those, and that will set the position of that circle. Okay, and in fact, I actually don't know. Do I want it to be 60? I don't. I want 360 degrees, and I want it divided by 5. I don't know what that is, but I can just type it right into the dimensions. See that? 360 divided by 5? And it will figure out that I want it at 72 degrees. So I'm just going to repeat that on a couple more of these. Draw center lines out. Okay. And then I will go ahead and dimension between each of these to be 72 degrees. Okay. It looks a little funny, and that is because we are not normal to that surface. So let me get normal to my sketch here. Okay, and there, the bolt pattern's looking a little bit better. 5 evenly spaced bolts, 1/2 inch, let's extrude those. Okay, and I'll extrude them, oh, let's go 1.5 inches. Okay, so now we have our bolt pattern centered on the plate. So just to review, a couple things to remember. Horizontal, vertical, equal, coincident, all are sketch relations that you want to get really familiar with and use a lot. All right, I think that's it for this video. Tune back in for our next one soon.